When a person dies an unnatural death, the soul is trapped in between universes.
कमाल है यार, तुम जिससे भी बात करती हो वो मर जाता है।
So when I was watching Typewriter, it took me back to the days when I used to read like Famous Five or like Secret Seven. You know, these bunch of kids who are trying to like investigate something, and you also wanted to be that kid who could actually find that haunted house.
Yeah.
And find some.
You thought that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Mission of, you know, mission sort of accomplished.
Yeah, yeah.
Done.
Yeah. As in,
so I mean, we can finish this interview right now.
No, I'm going to hold you back. So, what were your like influences, and how did you think of this?
Actually, exactly what you said. I mean, you answered your own question. See, when we were growing up, we didn't have all these TVs and internet and stuff like that. So we were predominantly books.
Mm.
And our books were Enid Blyton and Hardy Boys and Nancy Drew and The Three Investigators and Biggles and all kind of things which we are supposed to read and not supposed to read, but we read them all, right? And I think I was a very avid fan of Enid Blyton.
Mm.
So I think that stuck with me. And you know what you said about you felt like you yourself going in an adventure? That's how we used to feel when we used to read. And I always wanted to do something like that. To do something which a younger audience would enjoy.
Mm.
Where they would feel they are the protagonist and they are actually solving the mystery rather than the adults solving the mystery. And also, you expect an adult to solve a mystery. You don't expect kids to solve mysteries. And then when I met Netflix, they were equally, you know, enthusiastic about the whole thing. And they said, yeah, let's do this, let's do this. Now that finally it's done, it feels very nice. And if you say what you said, and fact is, I didn't pay him to say that.
But you have like most filmmakers say that it's really hard to like work with children because like, you know, it's...
Yeah, that's the cardinal rule.
And a dog also, like you have. So
kids,
like,
dog, water. You avoid all. At the end of the day, Nand, these are 9-year-old kids here. They're mm-hmm. kids like you. You should be out there playing. They should be also out there playing, you know. But instead, they're working.
Mm.
So their attention span is a little less than a goldfish,
mm.
you know. And I think the reason they say you don't work with a kid because, you know, as a filmmaker, we get a limited amount yeah. of hours in a day. Now, out of 8 hours, I would like at least 6 to be productive. But when you're working with a kid and a dog, your productive hours is like 2,
mm.
2.5. With luck, 2 hours, 35 minutes. But you know, it's a learning experience. I used to think after I did my ICSE geography exam, I thought, you know, I was invincible.
Mm.
But then after working with kids and dog, I am like super invincible.
From whatever the stuff you made, I mean, the most amount of success you've had is with your thrillers, right? So what do you think that you are able to bring to the genre that works for people?
See, what you are complimenting me on,
mm.
according to me, is a precondition for any filmmaker. You need whoever seeing it to be invested in it. Because every time we fail, the film doesn't work.
But
so that's it.
When I was watching Typewriter, I was like, how did you think of these moments where you can just suddenly like shock me? Like, how do you craft it?
I wish I had a very intelligent answer to that, but I don't.
It's just instinct.
It just happens, right? It's like a stockbroker. You take a call on a stock, it goes up, it comes down.
But you know, this is also like dark stuff. Like this kind of stuff doesn't happen. Like it's not even like you can say that I'm inspired by life or something. Or maybe partly, but like, where do these things really happen, right? So, imagination.
Yeah, in the head. But you know, that's what it's all about. You know, that's, it's like what we read between the line in Secret Seven or Famous Five.
Hmm.
It's like when you're reading an Enid Blyton and when Timmy is running towards the cave,
hmm.
you think, what can Timmy find inside the cave?
Hmm.
And what is in my head is what I put on the script.
You have said, I don't know if you said this, but you said that you don't actually like to live with your material for like too long, which is why you wonder how people can make like many seasons of the same show, because you like to like move on to like the next thing. So then what does a platform like this give you?
So I think I said that in context of film script, but series ka kuch aur DNA hai.
Hmm.
I mean, like before I wrote this Typewriter, I had to first unlearn everything I learned in writing a film.
Hmm.
Osa bhul ja, you know, those mm-hmm. don't work no more.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to relearn how to write a series. You know, it's completely fresh thing and much, much, much tougher.
You have so much more time, right? But isn't that...
Yeah, you know, like, I don't know. I made a short film called Ahalya.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Huh. That time I was crying my eyes out ke kyun mujhe sirf 12 minute diya ja raha hai to say a story. You know, like, why? You know, I need more time. I'm used to 2 hours. So somebody said, here's 5 hours, and I'm still crying. Like, why are you giving me 5 hours? I need...
So it's always the same.
Yeah, the grass is always greener on the other side. What happens is a series is a serious commitment.
Hmm.
And it's almost like being a doctor.
Hmm.
You have to be really committed to your series, your characters, your plot line, and it takes time. So what happens when you're going into a season two or a season three, you're more or less in the same world.
Mm.
Your world doesn't change.
Mm.
So I'm not sure if...
You can work around that?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe I can, maybe I can't.
Yeah, we'll know if there's another season of this.
Yeah, so...
What do you think you could do differently on this? Like, do you think there's some freedom that you got that you won't get in the movies? Is it the budgeting? Is it the fact that there's no box office pressure? What was the...
Yeah, that's a very, for me, that's a very common mistake people make. You know, people keep telling me, "Arey, it's the bahut achha, you know, there's no box office pressure, there's no money pressure, there's blah, blah, blah." But the pressure here is much, much more than a box office. If you think about it, I release my film on a Friday.
Mm.
At the most, there are three or four more films with me.
Mm.
Jada se jada. Now here...
So many shows.
Yeah, man. So how do I stand out of the clutter?
So many shows on so many platforms.
Correct. So, you know, that pressure of actually standing out is much, much bigger.
But at least if you get the window here, right? Like a small film is still struggle, but here it's there for 190 countries to see.
Yeah, but why will they see? Like if you go in there, you have Stranger Things, you have Dark, you have Unforgotten, you have Luther, you have When They See Us, you have Alana, Falana, Dimkara, and every day. So you're spoiled for choice. Mm.
But is this why you chose a barring Purab Kohli, like a relatively like fresh show cast? Because Follow Me has done work.
Yeah, I want...
Is that... Was that a conscious thing?
Yeah, you didn't, absolutely. You I didn't want...
Put a name to a face, basically.
Yeah, because then, given our structure, and I'm sorry to say this, but our structure is like that. And if you put a face in there, it sort of gets lopsided. So I wanted people who would be the characters rather than them.
Every director has that one film that people just love so much that they want them to do over and over again, okay? So like Imtiaz Ali said that how people want him to jabbi met all the time, that's like a point of conversation. And with you, it's of course Kahaani. Do you think that that's a shadow you want to move past or like...
Yeah, yeah. Is it? Ho gaya, Kahaani ho gaya. But I am what I am because of, you know, all my films. You know, it's not just Kahaani. I mean, it's also Jhankar, it's also Badla, it's also Halla, it's also Home Delivery. But yeah, people do remember Kahaani more than other films.
And they want it like that again. That's yeah. The scary part, right? Like,
but what they don't realize, they like it because of Vidya, not me. But I get all the glory. That's very nice of them. And it's good to hear because that's what I've signed up for, to hear these things, you know.
I'm hoping to find out what happens because I haven't finished the show, but I loved whatever I saw.
You saw, really?
Yes.
You're saying this on camera?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Please, note.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.